Hey folks, this is Sebastian, and for the holidays we decided to make some music. As you can see, you don't need much to make music. Maria will now show you how to build your own panpipes and how to tune them with phyphox.
You need an empty glass bottle. It's the best way to produce a sound, as it's not as easy to deform as a plastic bottle. In order not to spill anything, take a funnel and a container of water. Now pour the water into the glass bottle. Think about which note you want to use to tune the bottle. The higher the note, i.e. the higher the frequency, the higher the water level must be. Each bottle is different in height and shape, so the range of possible notes can vary from bottle to bottle. Now select the audio autocorrelation experiment in phyphox. Start the measurement, hold the microphone of your smartphone next to the neck of the bottle and blow over it to produce a sound. This may take a bit of practice. phyphox displays the frequency of the sound produced and the corresponding note. If your sound is too high, you need to tip some water away. If it is too low, add some more water.
When you blow air across the opening of the bottle, it acts as a Helmholtz resonator. When air is pushed through the opening, the air inside the bottle's cavity gets compressed. This builds up a force which pushes the air back out of the bottle, which in turn reduces the pressure inside the cavity. The system acts quite similar to a spring oscillator, but at frequencies that we can hear as a tone. This works for many different shapes of cavities, and the exact frequency depends on several geometric parameters, but generally, a smaller cavity leads to a higher frequency. So in our case, this means if we fill more water into our bottle, the air cavity above the water gets smaller and we hear a higher frequency.
Got your pipes ready? Then share with us which song you're gonna play on them. We will now set the mood for the holidays and see you soon in the next video. Bye!